What are you worried about regarding the future? What about the past is still haunting you? In this episode of Footsteps to Heaven, I would like to share with you the secret to having faith that transforms the future, transforms the past, and more than that, transcends it. Transcends the future, transcends the past. It's the secret to having such a profound relationship with God, God the Father, and Jesus Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the fullness of God, in order to have the joy that He wants for you right now, that He wants for all of us who are followers of Christ. No matter what's going on in the world, no matter what's going on in your life, you can have joy in the midst of it. The secret to being able to do that is to understand that God, although he's everywhere, he's in the past, he's in the future, but he's not wearing a watch. He's not looking at a clock. Time to him works very differently than time for us humans. God lives in the eternal now. Eternity is all an eternal now. Eternity is not a long stretch between one point in time until, you know, the infinite future. Rather, eternity is now, which is a now that encompasses the past and the future in such a way that, well, you know what? It's a mystery. We don't fully understand it. Maybe when we pass from this life into the next and join Jesus in heaven, then we're going to be living in the eternal now and we'll understand it. But right now we're kind of stuck in a timeline and we're trying to grasp how to have faith right now, because guess what? You need faith right now, right? You need hope now. You need joy now. You need peace now. You need God now. We all do. And in order to be able to enjoy that relationship with God in such a way that we have peace right now, joy right now, and everything else, fortitude, perseverance, hope, love, the love that God gives to us and the love he calls us to give to others. In order to have all of that right here and now, we need to understand that you already have it. You already have it all. Because if God dwells within you, if you belong to God, then, you know, if you're following Christ, and especially if you're filled with his Holy Spirit, because he gave us the Holy Spirit in order to live the Christian life, in order to have the faith that works miracles, in order to know what the Father is saying to us, in order to grow in holiness, Jesus gave us the Holy Spirit. We need to have a personal relationship with Jesus, our Savior, but also the Holy Spirit he gave us so that we could live the holy life that Jesus told us how to live, or what we're supposed to live, how we're supposed to be Christians. He exampled it. Jesus exampled it and he taught it. And, you know, just read the Gospels and look at what Jesus taught the Christians of those days. And look, well, the future Christians, and look at the book of Acts and see how the Christians right after Jesus lived out the faith. That's supposed to be normal Christian living. And we can have that too. We're supposed to have that. The way to have that is to realize that through the Holy Spirit and through the sacrifice Jesus Christ made for us, on the cross, giving his life for us, giving his time for us, coming down from heaven for us. And because the Father loves us so much, our relationship with God is a relationship of now. We experience God only in the now. God is experiencing us in the eternal now. We experience God in this moment of time. And that's all we have. We no longer have the past. We don't yet have the future. One of my favorite sayings is, I don't know what the future holds, but I know who holds the future. And then when I remind myself of that, I know it's time to let go. Let go of trying to control the future. Let go of worrying about the future because God's got it. And the only way I can do that is by remembering to live in the here and now. I learned how to get better at that many years ago when the Lord called me to travel to Malawi in order to give some courses over there. I had been invited by the rector of a seminary to come and teach for a week. I taught two courses, and the professors came to it, the seminarians came to it, and the religious came to it of the diocese, and the catechists of the diocese came to these courses. Now, I had never been to Malawi before. I had never been to any place further than Mexico or Canada at that point in time. And so, you know, traveling from Florida to Malawi, which was a 36-hour journey, was quite an interesting adventure. It was a challenge because I had never done it before and I was doing it alone. I was traveling alone. And, you know, fears told me, what if I fall asleep in the airport waiting for my next flight and I miss it? Or, you know, what if, you know, there's a whole bunch of what ifs that come to your mind. You know, my husband was thinking, what if the priest who invited her really isn't a priest, but, you know, is going to capture her into slavery or something. And, you know, there's a whole lot of what ifs that the devil tells us. The devil likes to ruin our joy and thereby ruin the now experience, the now relationship of union with Christ and the Father and the Holy Spirit. He likes to ruin it by giving us what ifs. Whether it's a what if, like in the past, what if I had done things differently? Now we can learn from that, but the minute we begin to feel bad about ourselves, feeling like a failure, feeling like, ashamed and whatever, if we sinned, we need to feel remorse and we need to repent of that. And then we're free of that. We can do our penance that's assigned to us by the priest in the confessional and we're done with it. God's done with it. We don't have to continue to feel bad about the past. We can learn from the past continually, but we don't need to feel bad about it anymore. And the future, we don't need to worry about the future because God's got it all. All we need to do is live in the here and now. So here I was going on this trip to Malawi. And when I got there, safely, of course, the priest, when he picked me up, you know, I decided on the way there that I was going to practice, take a further step in my journey of holiness by letting God totally lead the way through this priest or anybody else that the Lord wanted to lead through. That meant I wasn't in control of anything. It meant I didn't look at the time except for to make sure I got to class on time when I was going to teach it or to mass on time or wherever I needed to be on time. But I let this priest choose the time of and the locations of any trips we made. Like we went out into the bush to go to a funeral that he was presiding at. And there was various things that we did that I just let somebody else decide when, where, and how. I was letting God control each moment of my day by letting him lead me through this priest. And It was a life-changing experience. I let go of wanting to be in control. And I let go of fears. I just said, Lord, I am trusting this entire trip to you, and this priest has trust in you, and he's got a good connection with you. So what am I afraid of? There's nothing to be afraid of. And so I just went through that experience and came home changed by it, because I had learned how to let go of control, let go of worry, let go of anything having to do with the future, but just live in the here and now. The now of, okay, right now I'm in the bush country. Right now I'm on a bus going to a funeral out in the bush country, and we've picked up the choir from the cathedral in town, and they're singing wonderful songs in the language of Chichewa. I didn't understand the words, but the music, I understood the music. It was praise and worship, and it was a wonderful experience, and I enjoyed it because I was not thinking about what am I going to do when we get to our destination, or what am I going to teach in my next session of the class. Instead, I just enjoyed the here and now of listening to that music and participating in it with my spirit, because I couldn't participate with my lips because I didn't understand the language, but I certainly fully participated. And I've been working on that ever since. I've been living in that, enjoying the lesson that I learned there. And now let's bring it up to the present. We're living in a time when I've never seen rampant evil getting away with so much in my entire life before. You know, things that I was hoping would never happen in my lifetime are happening now. And some of these things I've been living with for a long time, and some of it's recent events in political history, in the national history, in church history, and so forth. And I'm like, Lord, what's going to happen? Where are we headed? There's things that are falling into place it's heading us more and more into persecution against Christians. Persecution against Christian morals is already very strong. And persecution against us Christians who stand up for Christian morals, we're on the way there. What do I need to think about? How do I need to prepare? What do I need to worry about? Am I going to be a martyr someday? What's that going to feel like? What's that going to look like? And I needed to stop that train of thought and say, wait a minute. There's a lot of what ifs and a lot of worry in there. Instead, I need to just say, hey, right now, in my world, in my little world of my home, my office, my work, my family, whom I'm with, my circumstances right here, the friends I'm with at the moment I'm with them, the church I'm in at the moment I'm in church, that little world of mine is where God is with me. That's my here and now. That's me being connected to the Lord of the eternal now. And it's a beautiful place to be. I keep saying out loud, I say it to my husband, I say it as a reminder to myself, all I have is the here and now, and I need to enjoy the here and now. This is what I have, and I can look for what to do today, what to do right now that is a blessing, that is joyful, that is glorifying God, that brings me joy because I'm glorifying God. That's the key. Live in the here and now. Realize that God is with you right now in your little piece of the world in this moment. Whoops, that moment's passed. Now it's this moment. No, that moment's passed. No, it's this moment. No, it's that. Hey, we don't have a now, because the moment we're in the now, it's the past. God has the now. God has the eternal now. And when we are united to Him in relationship, we are living in the eternal now, not because of us, but because of Him. And that means that we can relax, resting in the Father's arms, following Jesus, staying close to Him and letting Him lead the way, and hearing from the Holy Spirit what we are supposed to be doing, now, what we're supposed to be thinking now, what we're supposed to be praying now, who we're supposed to be serving now on behalf of the ministry of Christ. So now, my friend, let me pray for you. Hold your hands open in a gesture of, I want to receive now whatever God wants to give to me. In the name of the Father and Son and the Holy Spirit, we pray. I pray for each person listening to this podcast right now. Whatever the now moment is, because this podcast can be watched many times in the future. But for whoever, right now, you who are listening right now, this prayer is for you right now, and God is ministering to you right now. Even though I recorded this in the past, right now, God is ministering to you through this podcast. And as I pray for you, God is answering those prayers for you right now. Thank you, Father God, for being with us, me and the person listening. Thank you, Father God, for calling us to be together. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for coming into this world to take on our sins so that we could be freed from sin and freed from the devil's hold on us. Lord Jesus, deliver my friend who is listening to this right now. Deliver my friend from the strongholds of evil. Deliver my friend from the fears that the devil wants my friend to have. Deliver my friend from distrust in you, O Lord God, which is a lie from hell, because you are totally trustworthy. Lord Jesus, deliver my friend from all the lies and deceptions of the evil one. Deliver my friend from worry. Deliver my friend from guilt of the past that's already been taken to the sacrament of confession. Deliver my friend into your sacred heart, Lord Jesus. You know what are the desires in the heart of my friend who is listening to this podcast right at this moment. You know, Holy Spirit, what the Father wants to say in the heart and the mind and the soul of my friend who's listening to this podcast right now. Come, Holy Spirit, fill my friend from head to toe with an anointing of your grace, filling my friend like never before, more than ever before, with your love, your peace, your hope, faith, which is a gift from you, Holy Spirit, peace, which is given to us through the Holy Spirit from Christ as a gift from the Father. Fill my friend, Holy Spirit, with a special anointing that gives them a personal relationship, not only with Jesus closer than ever before, and also a deeply trusting relationship with God the Father, but more than ever before, also Holy Spirit, a deeper relationship, a more profound relationship, a more miraculous relationship with you, Holy Spirit. And now, my friend, I ask you to simply pray this. Come, Holy Spirit. You have my permission to change me. God bless you. Know, my friend, that right now, God is with you. God is hearing your prayers. God is answering your prayers. God is doing something for you right now. It's impossible for God to do otherwise. God loves you fully right now. And he cannot sit still. He cannot be inactive. He cannot sit idly by as he watches what's going on in your life. He's concerned about everything that you're concerned about. Let it go into his heart, into His hands, into His dreams for you, while you just sit back and relax in the eternal now that God is bringing to you in His relationship with you. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.